So the overall goal is restoration of lake sturgeon in New York. So if you look at sturgeon, they're long-lived, late-maturing species. So we've over-harvested them, dammed rivers, polluted water that killed their food source, macroinvertebrates, aquatic insects. So this is trying to bring those back, right?
DEC started broodstock collection here in 1996, and as partners have come on, as Fish and Wildlife Service has come on, the program has just gotten larger.
We've stocked over 300,000 sturgeon in New York, and these fish will hopefully outlive all of us.
Since Fish and Wildlife Service has taken over the lead of the egg take process, Region 6 Fisheries has sort of taken the role of the actual collection of the adult fish. We run 300-foot gill nets that are 8 feet tall. They have 12-inch bars in them, so they're really kind of species-specific. So each of these sturgeon that we handle, we apply a pit tag into them. It's a little microchip, the same chip you'd use in your dog or your cat, and recapture rate this year was really, really low compared to the past few years. So seeing a lot of new fish into the spawning population is a good sign.
We use an egg maturation assay or assessment. What we're doing is we're collecting a lot of eggs from each female that we deem to have viable eggs just from an initial observation of those eggs. We have a control group of eggs from each female and one that we're going to treat with progesterone, which is a powerful hormone. The progesterone eggs get a dose of progesterone. The control eggs don't receive anything. Both lots are put in a special solution to represent amniotic fluid. They're incubated overnight for 16 to 18 hours. The next morning, we remove the eggs from the incubator, still keeping them separated control and progesterone. They are boiled for about 2 minutes. They're cooled off. They're sliced in half, and then using a microscope, we analyze each half of an egg. What we're looking for is the germinal vesicle to be broken down in all of the progesterone eggs, and then at least a few of them in the control group of eggs. That ratio is really important to ensure that females' eggs are ready to be fertilized within that week's period of time. During the egg take process, we start by sampling the males. We collect milt from every male, and then the milt or the sperm is looked at under a microscope for motility. That way we know that that male is going to be a good candidate for fertilization for the female eggs. After that, we work with the females. We collect the eggs. We look and see what crosses we want to achieve to increase genetic diversity the best we can. Then the eggs are fertilized with the milt. They are sterilized with an iodine solution. They are treated with diatomaceous earth, which helps prevent eggs from sticking together. So after this event, we go back to our respective hatcheries.
And then we'll go ahead and raise the eggs, take them back and raise them to 7 inches long. And then they'll be distributed throughout New York State and some of their recovery areas. It's been a great partnership between the New York DEC and the Fish and Wildlife Service. Sturgeon are starting to come back, so we're real pleased.